Mark Leamer, and I want to welcome you to the first in my series of videos on the Malinois. Many people who have known me for a long time refer to me as Mark the Malinois Man. My friends in Belgium call me Mr. Mekelaar, and of course on YouTube, I'm the most interesting Malinois trainer in the world. And this guy right here, this is my buddy Robbie. I've had Robbie since he was 8 weeks old. His dad belongs to a friend of mine who got him from me as a puppy some years ago. Robbie's mother came from Holland as a puppy, and both of them have many generations of KMPV certified dogs behind them. I also owned Robbie's dad's dad and mom. You can watch his grandfather on my Doing Some Malinois Training video on YouTube. Robbie's a non-FCI dog. I'll get into that in my second video on Malinois registration and genealogy. Robbie has what I would call a moderate temperament. In part, it's because of the way I raised him, and the rest, well, it's genetics. He's not an over-the-top dog like his grandfather was. He's very easy to live with. It's possible to have a Malinois like that, but you don't always get that lucky. Robbie's a very manageable dog, very easy to work with. Most of what I've done with him has been through channeling drive to get what I want, just using eye contact, verbal commands, hand signals, hand gestures. He's had very little traditional leash and collar training. How about it, buddy? Now, most Malinois respond to and are very easily motivated, watch it, by toys, things like that to get their focus, to focus their attention, sometimes food. Robbie's not much of a toy-motivated dog. He does have good food drive, but mostly it's just the communication that he gets from me. He just likes to be my buddy and likes to please me. Don't you, Robbie? Huh? Not all Malinois are easy to work with. Most are, but not all. And when they're not, you must use other methods. I found that when you start early, you save yourself a lot of trouble down the road. Now I'm going to put Robbie away, and we'll get started. I'll be right back with you in just a minute. All right, buddy, let's go. Good job. Okay, I'm back, and we're going to get started on some things here. I'm going to be as brief on all of these as I can. We're going to start with overall temperament. A Malinois is a very high energy level dog. It's a very active and driven dog. It's a hard worker. That's why we like it so much for law enforcement. It's a great dog for sports, protection sports, and so forth. The dog can be very social if it's socialized at an early age. Malinois that aren't taken out and socialized when they're in the crucial stage, when they're 2, 3, 4 months of age, sometimes can be a little sharp, and that's a real problem. So the dog needs to be socialized early, and then it becomes a very social dog. Malinois enjoy challenges. They like to solve problems. That's why they're such a great dog to train. I just can't imagine why anybody who enjoys working dogs would want anything other than a Malinois. They're playful, usually very toy crazy, and of course those of us who train them use that to our advantage. If you're a person who's going to get a Malinois who's not going to maybe do something competitive with, you can still use the toy drive to your advantage. The thing you have to remember when you get a Malinois is if you don't do anything with the dog's going to get bored, it's going to become very destructive. Malinois can be very destructive in the home if they're left unattended and haven't been given any challenges, any problems to solve, any things to participate in. So if you're going to get a Malinois, make sure you want to do something with it. If you're not going to do anything with the dog, don't get one. The next thing I'm going to talk about is drives and instincts, mostly drives. Malinois have a tremendously high prey drive. Play drive, they just like to be active and do things. They like to hunt for things. That's why they make good drug detection dogs, explosives detection dogs. They're good for search and rescue, anything like that, because they love to just do something. They have the drive to do so many things. Most Malinois have a good appetite, so you can use food to your advantage in training for obedience and whatnot. Food is a reward. Most Malinois are retrieving maniacs. They have a very high retrieve drive, so you can use that to your advantage if you want to do dock diving or something. But they just love to, you can throw a tennis ball till your shoulder is sore and they'll just keep bringing it back. Defense drive, that usually doesn't come out in them until later, and we usually don't encourage it to come out until later. We use the prey drive and the play drive early on in the training of a Malinois to get it to do bite work and so forth. So try to keep that to a minimum at an early age. Activity options. There's so many things you can do with a Malinois. They're just super obedience dogs, very flashy, quick. You can watch videos on YouTube of Malinois doing obedience. I mean, it's just incredible. Agility, for their size, they're just incredibly agile. Gosh, they're just great athletes. They have a great nose, so they make good tracking dogs. They tend to track a little faster than shepherds, for example, in the sport of Schutzen. They usually get docked a little bit for tracking too fast. They make great search and rescue dogs. As I said earlier, the hunt drive is very high, so they love to do that. Any kind of nose work, and now they have fun nose work events for people. You don't have to have a drug dog or something to do nose work. It's a great new sport for dogs, and Malinois love it. Law enforcement, if you're looking for a dog to train for your department to be a drug detection dog, same as an explosive detection dog, Malinois is a great choice. Police patrol dogs, they've proven themselves many, many times over. When I first got involved in law enforcement in the 70s, probably 95% of the police dogs in America were German Shepherds. And now I would say probably at least 45, maybe 50% of them are Malinois. Malinois were even unheard of at that time. There are a variety of protection sports available to people in America today. For many years, there was just Schutzen, which is mostly now referred to as IPO. French Ring came along, Belgian Ring for a while. We had a KMPV organization for several years. There's a thing called PSA, Protection Sports of America. We had a thing that I started some years ago called PPD, Practical Protection Dog. There are lots of things like that if you want to do bite work, which the Malinois excels at, that you can participate in with your dog. If you have access to livestock and you want to do some herding, that's a great thing. And as I said earlier, dock diving, which is a new thing, it's fun to watch. And because of the athleticism of the Malinois, it's a natural star in dock diving. Special needs. Your Malinois, if you get one, needs plenty of attention. Plenty of attention. Plenty of exercise. You cannot get a Malinois and expect him or her to lay on the carpeting in the living room and watch TV with you or lay there while you play video games hour after hour after hour. That dog wants to go. Wants to go hiking, wants to go biking, wants to go swimming, wants to go do a dog sport, wants to do something. Go jogging with you. If you're an exercise enthusiast and you jog and you do whatever, a Malinois is a great dog to go with you. He or she will go with you for miles and miles and miles. But don't get one if you're not going to do something. A Malinois needs patience and consistency in training and just handling it in general, and you need to remain calm. A Malinois is a very excitable, high-drive dog, and it doesn't need an excitable owner. You got to stay calm, be consistent in what you're doing. It keeps the dog calm, keeps them from going way over the top. A Malinois needs a purpose in life. It needs something to do. It loves those challenges, as I said earlier. It's just not going to lay around and just be worthless like a chow or something like that. The dog needs to be socialized early on. The best thing is a puppy obedience class, dog park where if the circumstances there and the conditions are somewhat controlled, but a puppy class is the best thing, some kind of group where you have knowledgeable, educated dog people who understand that, you know, dogs need to interact, but you have to have some control and so forth. The last thing I want to go over quickly is other considerations. Excuse me, I have a cold. Small children, generally speaking, small children and Malinois do not go well together. So you might want to consider that. The running and screaming of kids, and many kids today are just so poorly disciplined that they run around and scream and carry on. That's just a natural attraction for a Malinois. It's like a rabbit or something running away, and that's how we have accidents and Malinois get a bad name. If you have a bunch of kids in the house, I would suggest you get something else. If you have other dogs, as is the case with any dog, when you get a new dog, you got to introduce the dog carefully. It might be difficult if you're going to use this dog for work and you want to emphasize this dog in the pack. That might be a little bit of a problem, but you have to consider that always on our dogs. Do you live in a house or an apartment? If you live in an apartment, it's just not fair to get a Malinois. If you live in a house and have a yard, it's much better if you can come home from work, get the dog out, go out in the backyard, throw the frisbee, throw the tennis ball, whatever, for a while so the dog can unwind. If you have some fields nearby or some big open areas, or even a park where you can go with the dog every day, that's great. If you have some kind of local training club, whatever it may be, an obedience club, an agility club, an IPO, Schutzen club, whatever, it's good to take the dog there and do some things with the dog so the dog doesn't drive you crazy. Okay? I hope these little things help you a little bit. My next video, which will be coming out shortly, is going to be on Malinois genealogy and registration. And I'll be talking about the dogs from the different European countries, the different gene pools, the dog sports over there, the differences in the dog, and what to look for when you're deciding where you want to get a dog and who you want to get it from. Okay? Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy. Bye-bye.